Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all having a great day so far. So today's video is going to be my what's in my hospital bag video for baby number two. Now, the first time I was pregnant, I did a couple different versions of this video. I did a what's in my hospital bag video before I got to the hospital when I was still very pregnant, similar to how I am right now. And it was like the most extra hospital bag video ever. I had so much excess stuff with me that I just didn't need. And then after I had my son, I ended up doing sort of like a take two of that. And I made a video all about what I actually used at the hospital and what I brought that I actually ended up using during my time in labor and my stay at the hospital afterwards. That video is actually, I think, my most viewed video ever. I think it's up to almost 1 million views now, which is insane. And so this time I thought it would be fun to do almost like, I guess a take three, I don't know, but basically show you guys what I'm packing for my second labor and delivery. I am 38 and a half weeks pregnant right now, which is crazy. And the time is just going by so fast. I honestly feel like I could go into labor any day now. I am feeling so ready, so close. So I wanted to make sure that I got this filmed for you guys and I got it out to you and I was able to show you what I'm taking with me. I truly feel like everything that I've got in this hospital bag for myself and the things I'm bringing for baby are things that I'll actually use. I'm not trying to bring a ton of extra outfits or a ton of extra things. I really just want to bring the essentials and the things that I know will come in handy. So I hope this video is helpful for you. If you're new here, I would love if you subscribe. That way I could have you join my YouTube family. And without further ado, let's get into the hospital bag video. Also, I will be showing you guys what's in my hospital bag and then what I'm bringing for baby, just a couple of the things I'm bringing for him. So last time I did a whole separate video for that. And honestly, I didn't end up needing a whole lot for the baby. My hospital gave me a ton of stuff. They sent me home with a bunch of diapers and wipes and all of that good stuff. So I'm really not bringing a ton for the baby himself. So today is sort of like a combo video too. What I like to do for my hospital bags when I go into labor is actually just use a small little travel suitcase like this, like a carry-on size bag. It's enough for my couple days stay in the hospital. My first time I did have a vaginal delivery. I'm planning on doing the same this time. And yes, I am planning on still going to the hospital amid this coronavirus chaos. I get one support partner. So as of now, my husband can come with me, thank God. So he will be having his own little hospital bag too, but our stay is going to be cut really short because we do have a toddler at home. And so just to give you guys a little bit of background info on what I'm bringing. So I really only need enough for like 24 hours worth in the hospital. I'm really not trying to overpack or bring too much stuff. I'm just trying to like get in there, have the baby, and then get home as soon as I possibly can because we do have a toddler that we need to get back to take care of. So that's kind of like a whole separate topic, but just wanted to fill you guys in on what my stay will look like. So this is prepping, assuming that I'm going to have a vaginal delivery again, unless something changes midway through and I do end up needing a C-section, but that's what I've packed for. So in my carry-on suitcase, that's where I put all of my clothes. That's where I put any postpartum prep items I wanted to bring with me, as well as like items to use actually in labor and delivery. So the first thing that I've got on top of my suitcase is my vlog camera. This is so important to me because I do want to vlog the labor. I have my video of my first labor and I absolutely love looking back on that. And so I definitely want to get a video of that as well. When I did this first hospital bag video, the first time I was pregnant, I got a lot of questions about the camera I use. This is a Canon G7X. It's just the one I use for vlogging. But any small type camera, if you are looking to take pictures or document the labor or take video, any small type of camera will do. I also love the Sony, I think it's the A5100. I'll link them both down below. But what I would recommend is getting some sort of little tripod like this to take with you so that you can prop it up and get a really good angle. There's another tripod, I should have brought it in here, but there's another type of tripod that you can actually bend and twist and mold, and that's what I used my first time around, and I love that because we could get the perfect angle no matter where the camera was set up. But either way, a camera to document the experience is definitely high on my list. I'm also bringing extra camera batteries and a charger and extra SD cards and just like fully stocking up on my camera situation because I really don't want to vlog the whole thing, document the whole experience, and then right as the baby's about to come out, my camera battery dies and I can't record it. So Just a pro tip if you are bringing a camera with you. I've also got a bag of toiletries with me. I do shower at the hospital, or last time at least I did take a shower while I was at the hospital. So I really don't need a full stacked bag of toiletries, but just the basics. And for me, this is the basics. So I've got like some face wipes just to like freshen up a little bit. I also have a toothbrush, toothpaste, a little loofah. I don't know why this razor is in here. I highly doubt I'm gonna be shaving at the hospital, but it's just in the bag. But I've got like a loofah, body wash, deodorant, and dry shampoo. So really I just need the bare bones essentials, like toothbrush and toothpaste, deodorant, body wash, and you're good to go. In my opinion, at least. Just something to wash my face and clean up a little bit when I can. I'm also bringing this little handheld fan. So this is something I showed in my first video, and I think that this was an item that people thought was really extra and unnecessary. But the first time I went through labor, you get so hot, especially when you're pushing over and over. So I pushed for 2 hours my first time, and you get really freaking hot. And this was something that I brought with me, and I actually forgot to pull out of the bag, but I wish I would have used. My husband ended up fanning me with like a toilet bowl thing that they gave him. So I did need moments of being fanned in labor. So I think a handheld fan like this is definitely a necessity. It's definitely something I'll be able to get use out of. This one I found on Amazon, and you can real easily just charge the battery and then fan yourself like this. This feels really good right now. But I like this one because you can actually charge it. You don't need to worry about AA batteries at all. So I also have the charger in my bag too. And then you fill up this little spray bottle and you can like mist yourself too. So I think that's awesome. I think it will definitely come in handy. This is in no particular order either. I'm just sort of grabbing random things out of this bag, but I also have a little pack of prenatal vitamins. So just because you deliver the baby doesn't mean it's time to stop taking your prenatals. These are just some extra. These are sort of like my backup brand or my backup bottle. These are the gummy ones, which I actually don't prefer to take, but I know that once I deliver, I might not have had a lot of food in me, or the next day I just might not feel up for taking my normal like horse pill prenatal vitamins. So I'm packing these just to make sure I get the folic acid and the DHA I need, but I think they'll go a little easier on my stomach too. So just sort of like an extra bottle. Plus then I can have these just packed and ready to go, and I still have my go-to brand in the kitchen that I'm taking every day until I go into labor as well. I've got a water bottle packed. A water bottle is an absolute must-have in your hospital bag. Set it out next to your hospital bag, have extras around the house, have it good to go. You get so thirsty and you wanna stay really hydrated, and I like a water bottle like this that has the actual spout that you can, I don't know what this is called, the mouthpiece, the spout, but it has this piece that you can actually drink from like that, so that when you're laying, if you've had an epidural or if you can't move or if you're just like in a ton of pain and you, for whatever reason you're laying down, you can still drink your water and not have to tilt your head back and not have to move around or sit up to drink it. It is like a game changer. It's the smallest detail, but I'm telling you, when you're packing your water bottle for your hospital bag, get yourself one with the piece like this so that you can drink it when you're laying down. It is a game changer. It's like an absolute necessity. Then I've got this little pack of essentials with various like random little items in it. So this pack is from the line Base, and it's just this like two-sided, it's got a clear opening on either side so you can see all of the items that are inside it. So on this side, we have these little name tags that say my name is. They're like little hello name tags. So we're gonna write the baby's name on there and take pictures to announce his name to you guys once he's born. I also have a random pen in there just in case we need to fill out any paperwork. They'll have pens at the hospital. Like, I'm really not worried about not having a pen, but it's one of those things that's just sort of like an extra thing that's good to have just in case. And then I'll put a permanent marker in here, like a Sharpie, to write on those name tags too. I'm also bringing my AirPods, my little headphones. So the first time I gave birth, I found that I've also got this pack of like Apple earphones, or like just like regular headphones, earpods in here. But I found that these headphones came really in handy for having phone calls after the baby was born, because everybody you know is gonna wanna call you when you announce that the baby's born. They're gonna wanna check in on you, especially right now because we are kind of in this height of coronavirus right now. I know that my family is going to want to check in and see how we're doing and make sure everything's okay. And it's really hard to have a phone conversation with a sleeping newborn baby on you, or to have, you know, a speakerphone or anything like that. So headphones come in handy because then you can have a phone call hands-free with your baby. So last time I had my son, I had a pair of just like regular Apple headphones with me. This time I'm bringing my AirPods because they'll be even more hands-free and I can just pop them in and then go about my day and still handle the baby the way I would whether I had them in or not. So I would definitely recommend bringing yourself some headphones and get yourself some AirPods if you don't have them, or some sort of wireless like Bluetooth headphone for phone calls too. Then on the other side of this little pack, this little case is so nice because it actually comes with a mirror as part of it. So if I need one, I've got it. But in here I have a Mophie portable charger. So something I've learned when your labor is long is that you're on your phone a lot. You kill a lot of time in labor. Up until the point where you're pushing, you're actually sort of just like hanging out, waiting for things to start, especially if it's your first labor. So I'm bringing a portable charger to make sure that I can keep my phone charged on me. I've also got the charger for the charger with me too. And then along those same lines, I'm bringing an extra long phone charging cord. So this is one of those 10 feet long cords, because when you're in the bed, you might not be able to reach an outlet really conveniently right there. So I want to have an extra cord with me. That way, wherever the outlet is, I can plug my phone into charge and still use it when I'm laying in the bed too, in the hospital room. And then I've got a couple just like little hand lotions and body lotions. These are the Stress Fix line from Aveda, or these are both from the Stress Fix line by Aveda. This is my favorite line. It's so funny. I actually had these set aside from my first labor, and I do remember pulling these out and using them when I was in labor. They have a really nice natural lavender scent. It's clinically proven to reduce your stress levels. Seems a little extra bougie, but I did take advantage of them the first time and whip them out and just like put a little bit on my hands and smell the scent, and it helps relax you a lot. So I'm planning on keeping both of those with me. And then I actually have this rollerball. This is like a lavender rollerball as well that my sister-in-law gave me as a gift when I was pregnant the first time. And I just love the scent of lavender. It's so relaxing and calming. So I have that in here as well, just sort of as a random thing. I've got a pack of hair ties too. These little hair coils are my absolute favorite kind of hair ties. You are gonna wanna keep hair ties with you when you're in labor. You don't need a ton. Last time I remember I brought this like whole whopping big ring of like 100 hair ties. You don't need a ton, but bring two or three in case you lose one. But these little hair coils are really nice to just throw your hair up and get it out of your face, and I definitely want to be able to do that. And then the last thing I've got in this little pack are these After Ease for Pregnancy drops. I talked about these in one of my vlogs, but I got these on Amazon. I've heard they're amazing. I heard they work really well. Really what they're supposed to do is they're supposed to help with the contractions that you have after the baby's born. So one of the things that really surprised me when I had my son is that the contractions do not stop once you have the baby. They actually can sometimes be a little stronger afterwards. As your body is sort of like coming to after delivering a baby, the uterus starts to contract to shrink back down to size, and it especially does it when you're breastfeeding. So when you're breastfeeding, it can be really painful because your uterus is like contracting back down at the same time. So these drops are supposed to help with that. You can just drop them in tea, or you can drop a couple in water. And I wanna make sure to start having those in the hospital as soon as I deliver so that it can just make the pain a little bit better. I've also heard that that like postpartum contraction feeling can be worse with each pregnancy. So given that this is my second birth, I'm anticipating it to be a little stronger. So these will hopefully help combat that. I will warn you, I have not even opened these yet and they smell so strong. Like it's a very, I don't know, it doesn't smell bad, but it's a very natural like herbal scent. So if you're sensitive to that, or if that might bother you, just something to keep in mind. You might wanna like lock it up and put it somewhere else, because I've had this little thing in this suitcase in our guest room for, I don't know, like a month or a couple weeks now. And when you open the guest room door, you can smell it. Like it's very strong. So just something to keep in mind. But I'm excited to see how those work. And I would definitely recommend keeping all of these little knickknacks like that in one place, just so that it's easy to find. If there's ever a question of like, where are my headphones or where are those drops? I just know they're in this pack and I can instruct my husband to go grab it out of the bag and he'll know where it is and it makes it really easy. I've also got this mom washer with me. I actually don't think it's called the mom washer anymore, but it's this Freedom Mom like take on the Perry bottle. So the hospital will give me Perry bottles, I know, for like spritzing down there and cleaning up afterwards, because after you have a vaginal delivery, you can't wipe if you go to the bathroom or anything like that. This bottle is supposed to be amazing and game changing for that. As you can see, you just squirt it up there, versus the typical Perry bottles that are more standing and can be a little bit, you know, messier or whatever. I didn't use this my first time around, but I heard it's amazing. I heard it is much more like easy to use, much more cleanly, and is just like a game changer in that aspect. So I'm bringing this with me. Honestly, I don't know how much I'll use it in the hospital. I have a feeling I'll probably use it more once I'm home from the hospital, but either way, I just figure it's good to have in the bag. The little bag it comes in says, "Trust us, your vagina will thank you." And I believe them. I think my vagina will. And then I also have this pack of Freedom Mom Perennial Cooling Pad Liners. I also talked about these in a vlog of mine. These are just essentially those like witch hazel cooling pads that you line your actual pad with to provide a little bit of relief. I know my hospital is going to gift, I keep saying I know my hospital. I'm assuming they have all these supplies on hand because last time they gave me these things, but my hospital typically will give some sort of like witch hazel aloe pads to go on the pad that you're wearing. So I don't feel like I need these. I don't feel like they're a necessity, just knowing what my hospital gives. Every hospital is different, so I'm not saying that yours will give you those things. You can definitely double check with your hospital. I would recommend, if you're getting close to delivering, I would recommend talking to your doctors, or I would recommend talking to L&D, labor and delivery, and seeing what they give so that you know what to pack. Like I said, I don't think these are a necessity, but I've got them in my bag just in case I don't like what they're giving me, or just in case they don't have supplies, or I don't know. I just figure, why not? And then along the same lines, I'm also bringing two of these Depends diapers. Now I have, they're not actually diapers. They're like feminine underwear. They look like this. I get the pretty ones with the little pattern because they're oh so sexy. But these things are amazing when you are postpartum and you are recovering. If there's anything that you should stock up on or that I would recommend trying to recover from delivery, it's these. You may not find yourself needing them for very long. I think I wore them for like a few days, but this is what I opt for versus like the whole mesh underwear ice block situation that the hospital will have you wearing. I think I did that for the first day postpartum when I had my son, and then I switched into these and I actually wore these coming home from the hospital. This time, because I'm anticipating our stay to be pretty quick, I don't know if I'll even have the chance to get in them, but I figure if I just bring two, that's a good start. I'm not bringing any additional pads or anything like that because my hospital will give me those things, but I do want to have my Depends because my Depends are a necessity when I'm recovering from labor. I'm also bringing just one set of these breast pads for milk leakage. My milk likely won't come in while I'm in the hospital. Last time it came in 2 days postpartum, so my first day back home. This time, because I'm hoping to come back home sooner, I really don't think my milk will even be in while I'm in the hospital, but just in case, I don't know if those things like move faster your second time around. Let me know if it did for you. But I had a very high supply of milk with my son, and so I just figure better safe than sorry. I'm not bringing a ton, but I do want to have like one set of breast pads just in case I'm leaking or anything. And then I'm bringing this little makeup bag. Now, it is so funny. So many people have very strong opinions about bringing makeup in your hospital bag to the hospital with you. And you know what I say? I say, you do you, girlfriend. You do whatever you wanna do. If you wanna put some makeup on when you're going into labor, you put some makeup on. If you wanna put some makeup on before you go home from the hospital, you do that. If you don't want to, then don't bring it. It is totally up to you. It's a total personal choice. I'm not saying makeup is a necessity in your hospital bag, but what I am saying is that I like to have a little bit of touch up. It helps me feel more human after I give birth. Last time my water broke and I literally sat down and I put some makeup on and I wanted like a little bit of face, and it helped me get my thoughts together and like kind of breathe a little bit before I headed to the hospital. And then I packed just like a little bag of just a couple quick travel size necessity, like my go-to makeup items, travel size, in a bag like this. This one's actually empty because I'll probably wait until you know, I'm about to leave and just pack a couple things in there real quick. But I learned the first time, it also takes a long time to be discharged from the hospital, oftentimes. Not every hospital, but in my experience, it took a while. So they would say, for example, okay, we're gonna get you wrapped up to go home. And we didn't get to go until 2 or 3 hours later. So for me, I used that time to put a little bit of makeup on, to pull myself together, to feel just a little bit more human after delivering a baby. And it made a really big difference, especially because I do want to vlog and have a video of this and put it on YouTube and stuff like that. So I'm planning on bringing just a little bit of makeup with me, just some of my favorite items to help me feel a little bit more fresh and a little bit more like myself afterwards. If that's not your style, then just feel free to disregard that item suggestion. So as far as clothes, like I mentioned, I don't want to bring a ton of things with me clothing wise because I know I'm going to have my hospital gown on while I'm in labor. I'll have it on for a while after labor. They're constantly coming in and checking you. When you're breastfeeding, you're basically just chest out the whole time anyway, so it's just sort of easier to just stay in the hospital gown, in my opinion. But I am bringing a couple of these like nightshirt options. I found these at Target and they're just a long sleeve, really comfortable PJ nightshirt. I have a couple different designs of them or like colors of them. This is just a green striped one and then I'm also bringing this gray one. I like them because they're long sleeve, they're super soft, and they're nursing friendly because they have the buttons. So I brought nightgowns with me my first time around and did end up changing when I could, when I, you know, was ready to get out of the hospital gown. Putting on just some comfy PJs makes the biggest difference with feeling like yourself. Again, if you don't want to put makeup on, if you don't want to change your outfit, you definitely don't have to. But for me, I know I did it the first time, so I'll probably do it this time around as well if I can. These like shirt dress PJ options from Target are awesome. They're super cute for spring, and then they'll be good for postpartum recovering at home too. And then I'm bringing a pair of slippers. I've talked before about how slippers are a must-have for me when I'm pregnant. They keep me comfortable. They give me some cushion on my feet. I also like to wear them around the hospital room. There's just something so nice about slipping out of your hospital bag and into a nice pair of cozy slippers. So I am bringing a pair of slippers. I wore them last time. I know I'll wear them this time, because they are something that makes a really big difference on my overall comfort of the stay, but also just, again, feeling like myself. Like, in my experience, when you deliver a baby, you're sort of in this fog, and then you go from being pregnant and having this body that took a while to get to this point, to all of a sudden you're in a whole new body, like boom, like that. So it helps to have these little things, in my opinion, that help you just feel a little bit more like yourself, you know? One more nightgown I'm bringing too is this one from Kindred Bravely, but this nightgown is so pretty and it's more of a tank style. So if I get really hot, this may be a better option for me than the longer sleeve styles. And this one is nursing friendly too. I love these like nursing friendly tank pajama dresses like this postpartum, and this is actually a little closer to the style I changed into my first time, so I'm bringing that. And then I also have this really pretty robe from Kindred Bravely. I've talked before about them. They're one of my favorite maternity like postpartum brands, but this robe is really pretty as well too. So just bringing like a lightweight robe in case I want to wear the tank nightgown and bundle up a little bit. I mentioned I would only be there for a day or so, and I'm bringing like, you know, 3 or 4 different pajama options, but I just don't know how I'm gonna feel heat wise and comfort wise after delivering, so that's why I'm bringing a couple extras of those. And then for coming home, I have a couple nursing bras. The reason why I'm bringing 2 is because I don't know how my chest is going to change after I deliver, but typically any sort of like sport nursing bra like this, anything that's knit and that's really comfy and cozy. I just got these ones at Target, and this is like a sport style, comfy, stretchy nursing bras. These are like a go-to of mine, so I'm gonna throw one of these on for the way home. I've got a comfortable pair of shoes, which I'll actually probably take out of my bag and just place it next to my hospital bag. That way, whenever it's time to go to the hospital, I can slip these on, take my bag with me, and then I only have one pair of shoes with me and I can wear them home from the hospital too. But comfortable slip-on shoes like this are a must. My Adidas slides are a great one. I've seen people going home in flip-flops a lot, regardless of the weather. Something that you don't even have to think about putting on that you can just slip your feet into is an absolute must when you're heading home from the hospital and you've got a million things and this little human being that you're packing up at the same time too. So these are just a pair that I got from Target last year and I wore them nonstop and they're really comfortable. So those will just be sitting right outside my hospital bag, ready for me to wear to and from the hospital. And then I have a couple like really soft, cozy outfits to wear home. This like two-piece set, so these are some just striped shorts from the PJ section at Target, and then this matching striped sweater too. But in case it's cold, I also have a pair of jogger sweatpants too. So just really comfortable fabrics, but also separates. I love a good jumpsuit or a good dress or something like that too, but I know I'm gonna be needing to breastfeed like, you know, every 2 hours at that point. So I want something that's separate. That way I can just lift my shirt up and have really easy access there. Then a couple other items I wanted to mention that I'm bringing just for the room in general. Blankets and pillows are a must in my opinion. Hospital blankets are very thin on the bed and hospital pillows are very thin too. Again, this sort of speaks to just like making it your own, getting really comfortable, but I find that when I'm trying to sleep in the hospital or if I'm just trying to get comfortable in the bed, we ended up bringing pillows and blankets from our place last time. So this time I just packed or I picked up this like super soft blanket from Target and I just have it next to my hospital bag. I'm not even going to open it until we get there because it's just easier to transport this way, and I'll probably just grab a pillow from our bed too. Bringing those types of things for your partner who's probably going to be laying on the couch or whatever seat they give the person in the room, those are really crucial too. They just really help you stay comfortable, and this one is so soft. It's so warm and cozy, so had to grab an extra blanket to bring with us. Then I'm bringing our boppy. This is actually my boppy from the first time around, so I brought this to the hospital with Christian. I used it nonstop with Christian, washed it, held on to it, washed it again, and now I'm bringing it for baby number two. But the boppy really comes in handy when you're getting the hang of breastfeeding in the hospital. And I breastfed Christian until he was 15 and a half months old, but it's obviously been a while since I've breastfed a very brand new newborn. So I'm bringing my boppy, that way if I need a little bit of extra support, I can use it. I found myself using this a lot the first time around in the hospital. And then this is gonna seem weird to some of you guys, but I'm bringing a cooler because I actually take my placenta with me and I have it encapsulated so that I take it as pills afterwards. I did that the first time around. This time I'm doing the placenta, a tincture, and then I'm also gonna get little placenta like smoothie prep so I can have placenta smoothies. Y'all might think that is crazy. I know some of you guys are probably like, oh my gosh, that's disgusting, but it's what I do. So part of it is that the woman who is encapsulating it for me, you can find like a local place on Yelp or, you know, do your research to find things like that. But the woman who's encapsulating it for me just has us bring a cooler, fill it up with ice, and then she's gonna meet us outside the hospital whenever we leave and we'll do the placenta handoff that way. My hospital doesn't let us leave with the placenta and doesn't let anyone pick it up until we're discharged. So we're just gonna, they'll actually hold it on ice until we're ready to go home. And then when we're ready to go home, they'll hand it to us. We put it in the cooler and I'll hand her the cooler. So I've got a cooler for my placenta set aside. And if you wanna know benefits to eating your placenta or taking your placenta pills or things like that, I'd be happy to go over that in a different video too. But essentially, it's just to balance out your hormones, prevent postpartum depression, help put some of the nutrients back into you and back into the baby and the milk you're feeding the baby, put some of those nutrients back in that you just let out during labor. There's a lot of great benefits to it, way more than that too, but that's just a high level view of it. Then for the baby, For the baby, I'm not bringing a ton, like I said. One thing that I definitely want to bring with me is our baby book. I love to do this because there's actually a page in here where our hospital can mark his footprints. So there's actually a spot in here to mark the footprints and the handprints, but my hospital only does the footprints. But I love that. We did it with Christian, and it's so cool that we have this imprint from right away as soon as they could do it, and it's in his baby book right there. You can see how tiny his foot was when he was born. So bringing the baby book just for that purpose. I've got instructions from my hospital in here just so that I can remember like what entrance to go to or if I need phone numbers to call. Similarly, I'm also going ahead and going through my email and bookmarking any emails for my maternity leave for the people who process like the finances and stuff like that. Just get yourself set up in that space as much as you can, because a lot of that paperwork needs to be processed and updated once the baby's here, and you are in such a fog at that point, it's easy to forget. So I'm trying to get all my paperwork and everything set up in advance, that way I'm just good to go and I can hit submit once the baby's born. I'm also bringing this just little handheld pump by Medela. This was sort of like my travel pump when I was pregnant or after I had Christian, whenever I needed to pump on the go or just get a little bit of milk. I don't think I'll need this. I didn't need a pump the first time, especially since I'm anticipating our stay being relatively short this time. But just in case, you know, if I'm having trouble getting the milk going or if we're having trouble getting colostrum out or something like that, I don't think this can hurt. I don't need the full-blown pump set up, but just a handheld one like this to kind of get it going, I think is good to have just in case. One thing that I found this time around that is super cool is this thing called Newborn Nest. Now, this is kind of an investment, so I'm not saying it's necessary at all, but I found them on Instagram and I thought it was the cutest company and I really wanted to have it for our hospital stay. So what it is this set that comes with little sheets and a whole little outfit that matches that can go in the hospital bed for the newborn. This smells so good because I washed everything, but it comes with a little fitted sheet for the hospital bed for like their little bassinet in the room. It comes with a fitted sheet. It comes with a nightgown for the newborn, a matching hat. There's also a bow in here if you're having a girl. And then it came with this really cozy blanket too. So this will be great for bringing him home and using this in the car seat. I just think it makes for the cutest pictures. It's so adorable. And they were running a sale on it, so I snagged it because I had been eyeing them forever, and I really love the idea that it just makes their little baby hospital bed like a little bit more aesthetically cute, and then they have this whole outfit and it, I don't know, like the cutest pictures and everything. So it's a very small detail, like I said, not necessary, but something I'm bringing with me, so wanted to show you guys because I think it's a really cute idea. I'm also bringing a car seat cover. So this is one of those car seat covers and like nursing covers if you want to use it as a nursing cover too, but I figure if the day is really sunny out or if it's extra warm, which I don't think it will be, it's been gloomy here, the heat hasn't really hit SoCal yet, but just in case. I remember when we left the hospital with Christian and I was like trying to hide him from the sun so much and it was stressing me out, so just bringing a little car seat cover in the baby's bag I think will help a lot. I also have this shirt packed in here for Christian that says Big Bro. So cute. I'm so sad he won't be able to. I packed it in here because I was hoping he could wear it into the hospital to meet his brother there, but so I'm so sad that he won't be able to, but I still want to set it aside so whenever we introduce the boys, when we bring this baby home from the hospital and Christian meets him for the first time, I want him to have his little Big Bro t-shirt on too. I just think that is the cutest idea. And then we just have other like random little coming home outfits. I've got a couple hats in there, and then I'm bringing like some little booties to keep the baby's feet warm too. Their feet are so tiny, so I've got little booties in here and little socks too, just dependent on his size. And then I've got like some coming home outfits like this as well. So lots of cute Instagram pictures to come. Like I said, I'm not bringing a ton for him, but I did just want to have a couple outfits and a couple things, especially to keep his feet warm on the way home. I'm also bringing a little pacifier teething clip too. It has his name on it, so I don't want to show it, but like just one of these pacifier clips that will hold his pacifier in just for the drive home if we need it. And that's it. So I know this video was longer than anticipated, as most of mine are, but I really wanted to be thorough in showing you guys the things I'm bringing for baby number two and the things I know I'll need. I truly feel like everything in this video, even though it's a lot of stuff, I really think I'll be using everything that's in here. Hopefully I have a very quick and smooth delivery during the daytime and it's not panicked and not rushed, but I feel like I'm pretty stocked up and ready to go either way, no matter how this goes down. So I hope this helps some of you guys if you're packing for your first time around or for your second time or just packing in general. I hope this helps you, some of you guys, and gives you some ideas. Let me know anything else that you guys would like to see. I do have a couple more videos I'm trying to pump out while I'm still pregnant over the next week or two, but I think this baby boy is coming soon. So thank you guys so much for watching. Leave me a comment and say hi. Congratulations to all you mamas who are watching out there and expecting yourselves, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.